and welcome to Big Brother's Little Brother. It's day 9, the time is 7:32. So, it's been a big day in Big Brother 2007. As you may have heard, at 3:28 this morning, Emily was called into the diary room and removed from the Big Brother house. Now, she broke a fundamental Big Brother rule by using language that could be offensive to both housemates and the viewing public. So, we're not going to show you the clip of that because, in fairness to everyone involved, you have to see the whole thing in context to have a judgment, which you can see tonight at Channel 4. Now, at 9:33 a.m. this morning, it was down to Leslie to inform the rest of the housemates that Emily was gone.
Housemates, on the day that you entered the Big Brother house, all housemates were reminded of the Big Brother rules. Emily has broken a fundamental rule of Big Brother and has been removed from the Big Brother house. The rules regarding unacceptable behaviour clearly state that Big Brother will intervene and take appropriate action if housemates behave in a way that Big Brother considers is unacceptable. Oh, unacceptable behaviour includes behaving in a way that could cause serious offence to either their fellow housemates or members of the viewing public, including serious offence based on the grounds of race. The rule clearly states that housemates who act in a way that is seriously unacceptable will be evicted. Tomorrow's eviction has been cancelled.
OK, there we go. So, Emily is gone, therefore there's going to be no eviction this week. As far as we're concerned on BBLB, it's back to business as usual from this point. Joining us today to separate the movers from the shakers is film buff, music man, all-round cool customer, friend of the show, Alex Zane's with us. Men want to be in, girls want to get off of him. Plus, coming up, we find out what happens when you cross a Women's Institute annual general meeting with Nikki Graham from Big Brother 7. That's not nice, by the way. But before that, we want to hear from you in Little Brother's Big Shout today, so get in touch with us by any of the following means. Give us a call, 0871 200 1040. Text your comment to studio and your comment to 83188 or email us, send pictures, blah, 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 to channel4.com/BBLB. Now, it's fair to say that Ziggy hasn't had the best couple of days in the house. Loads of arguments. Big arguments, in particular with Emily and Charlie. The honeymoon is certainly over. With that in mind, today's topic for discussion is, how do you think Ziggy is coping in a house full of lovely ladies? Get your texts and emails in right now, please. Have your say. OK, that's what's been happening. It's time to find out, rather, what's been happening since first thing this morning. It's Little Brother's Big News. At 1:38 this afternoon, the housemates were given a welcome treat when the bathroom ban was lifted. Big Brother also presented our housemates with a luxury pamper hamper. Take a look.
Leslie.
Yes.
Earlier this week, Big Brother banned housemates from using the bathroom. This ban is now lifted.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, yes. You're your puppy, Charlie.
Oh, yes.
Show us what
we've got.
I'm so sorry. I've just got excited because I haven't used this for ages. Look! Shine spray!
My God.
Girls, are we having a pumper night tonight?
Yeah.
At 2:04 this afternoon, the housemates were given a clean bed linen. Now, question. How many housemates does it take to change a bed? Answer.
Mate, you know what? I'm just going to sit and watch this.
Girls, this is the easiest way to watch. Pillows.
That way.
It's you, right, girls?
Put it down. Oh, my God. You lot. I'm not exaggerating. How does this go?
This doesn't seem big enough for the...
It stretches over the bed.
It doesn't stretch far enough.
It's honestly not big enough.
This, they've given us a small sheet on purpose.
Crazy.
I put the wrong one in, I think.
Took it over here.
Yes. And again.
You go in one corner and I'll go in the other.
Yeah,
that's what I'm saying.
Oh, so it's inside. You know.
Right,
stop. Put your hands in. I say, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Sorry.
They're so unbelievably rubbish at everything. I can tell you it took 9 of them 1 hour and 2 minutes to change their bed sheets. 1 hour and 2 minutes. And lastly, at 3:50, the all-girl atmosphere finally got to one of our housemates. Not Ziggy, but Tracy, who after 15 years of abstinence finally succumbed to a makeover. Have it.
Hello, big brother.
Hi. Tracy's wearing makeup today. I give her a makeover and she looks absolutely stunning.
It's not a different house, mate. It is Tracy, still believe. They just wanted me to show you for some
look,
really weird reason.
You look stunning. It's unbelievable. It's really such a... I'm like, oh, my God. But she said it's not her because she doesn't like to wear makeup and stuff like that, which is amazing because she's beautiful without it. But I just think she looks so amazing.
I don't recognise myself. I really don't recognise myself.
I dumb head in. You look stunning.
Proper dumb head in. I just don't feel myself.
Oh, look at it. Please have
a look.
I
just don't feel myself.
Have a look.
What do you think? Do you like that?
Yeah!
Yeah, a lot of guys like that, right? Tracy there. How's Little Brother's Big News? With us on the show today, a man who knows a thing or two about music, films, and how to handle lovely ladies. It's Alex Zane, everyone! Good to have you with us.
Do you know what? Watching that news, I think because she's partied quite so hard, Tracy probably genuinely doesn't recognise herself anymore.
That's true. She's looking at herself going, I don't...
Where am I in this reflection?
OK, this year so far.
Yeah.
Discuss.
Wow. Ziggy. Mm-hmm. I initially was like him, envious. To a point. I do like the fact you've called me a ladies' man as well.
You are a ladies'
I'm
man.
I'm really not.
Ladies like you.
You see, this is the thing. I was watching Ziggy and initially I was like, oh, okay. But if Ziggy is in a position where he can't deal with what's going on in that house, then there is absolutely no way I could.
Well, that's true, because he is a brilliant ladies' man, isn't he? There's no doubt about it.
He was the kind of guy who was in the football team at school. I was captain of the chess club.
Yeah.
He had a girlfriend. I was the only kid in school to carry a briefcase.
Just to put that into context, I was 6th in the chess club at school, so... he's been in the house almost a week now. There's no way you could handle being in there for a week.
No, right? Not at all. It's the only comparison I've got for the way the girls are from time to time in that house is the movie Jason the Argonauts with the harpies when they're stealing the food from the blind
These
man.
These are the big things, are they?
They're the blue flying birds.
OK. And they come down... and he's Jason? Just sort of, what, fighting them off, or...?
He's the blind man who desperately wants to keep his food.
I know that.
His sanity. His food is the sanity.
No, I don't think Jason the Argonauts or any Greek mythology has ever been mentioned on BBB. Thanks. Yes. BBB first. It started so well for Ziggy, it's been going downhill for the last couple of days. Take a look.
Are you telling me this room is all girls?
Give the guy some space, ladies.
This is good. No, this is great. This is exactly what I was looking for.
It's a wonderful, wonderful experience. I can't tell you how good this feels.
Charlie, just chill out.
Girls, I'm gonna stick a bit of manly thing here. I'm going to say we're going to take it. On my first night, I ain't having any room.
Now, I'm finding it hard being the only guy in here. And I'm just testing it a bit, and I'm not, I don't think I'm doing very well.
You know what I'm doing? I'm not doing with it. I can't.
Please.
I can't.
Oh, girls.
There's been loads and loads of rowing over the most useless stuff.
What's the point arguing about this? Emily.
I'm just finding things hard with bitching and all this, and I seem to be getting involved, and it's hard not to. It's hard because you just get dragged into these things.
I'm not lying.
Yeah, I said the words game plan. I did not say the words in a sentence.
I think Chanel has a game plan. She's good with you. Fine. Drop it.
I just feel a little bit lonely, to be honest with you. Really, I'm just on my own.
Why would I be so bitchy to you? I don't understand.
Hang on.
Actually, you know what? I don't know why I'm getting involved, seriously.
I miss my mum, I miss my dad, I miss my brother, I miss my sister.
That moving. It's gone wrong the last couple of days. Why do you think it's gone wrong the last couple of days?
Do you know what I actually think it is? I think it's because he picked his mate in the house too early.
Chanel,
yeah, I think I'd have held off, despite the fact he might genuinely fancy her, and I think he does. I don't think there's any game plan there. I think he really likes her.
Mm-hmm.
And I think I think if it's like lions in the wild, you see, but not. Because lions in the wild, if he was the male of the group, he'd pick his female and all the other female lions would bow down to the queen lion.
I don't like that.
But we're humans, so consequently, they're like, her over me.
There's an element of truth there. Because, I mean, the next question is, how do you think he can last without male reinforcements? But the reason I ask that is, he's almost kind of... When he first came in, he had this power, yeah? Mm-hmm. But now he's nominated. Now's the time... Since nomination, that power's almost taken away from him, you know, because they don't need to impress him anymore.
Well, initially, yeah, they were sort of going, with the big tail feathers out.
So what should he have done? Literally just not being a bit too obvious? Because I guess within maybe, like, 36, 48 hours, he was there saying, yeah, she's a really pretty girl, and that made everyone else go, oh, hang on a second.
Well, yeah, I think when we saw him having the dinners, the dinner with each one individually, that was when he was at his best, because he played, and he was very good at that. He played each of them exactly right, which is a real skill he has, that he can play the
Absolutely,
people
Absolutely, because he's been terrific with Leslie, he's been terrific with Carol, but you raised a brilliant point there, because even within that task, he only had one chocolate to eat with Chanel, and it took him 50 minutes to do so, 5-0. Do you think more men going in is going to make his position weaker?
Depends on the man. It depends. I think Siggy would probably quite like someone to go in who he could reenact scenes from Gillette adverts, you know. Yeah! Yo, we're men together.
Let's throw some balls!
It depends whether... Swing for it! it depends whether they're happy, because he's clearly the dominant male in there, and he will be just because he's been in there the longest. So if they're happy to come in and bow down to the altar of Ziggy, uh-huh. then he'll be fine. It's a challenge. That
I know, like. Obviously, our researchers talked to you before. You like Carol, don't you?
I do like Carol.
Just to change subjects.
I do, yeah. I fancy Chanel a little bit, just because I think she'd make a good girlfriend, because I read in the papers that she once thought Bungle from Rainbow was a real bear. Now, tell me that isn't a brilliant girlfriend. You would always be the cleverest person in the world. You'd just go...
And you'd spend your whole time going like this. I really love you.
Yeah. Do you know what, honey? He's not a real bear.
But
he's a man in a suit.
But you like Carol
yes,
too,
Yes, I do,
right?
Sorry, yeah,
Good,
I do.
Because we put together a Carol montage.
Yeah,
no,
I like her.
Make me happy through the years. Never bring me the tears. Let your arms be as warm.
Pamela Anderson, isn't it?
Whoops. Bring me fun.
No
bring
diving.
Me sunshine, bring me love, sweet love. Bring me fun. Bring me sunshine. Bring me love.
No cows are harmed in the recording of this programme.
With everything that's going on in that house, it's brilliant to have some light relief. It's like the end of Titanic with the Chuckle Brothers in the background doing a slapstick sketch when she appears. It's great.
Finally, who are you backing to win?
I'm actually backing Nikki to win.
Really? Interesting.
I like her mind.
OK.
I think she's great.
She won't like you because she hates men. She'll get you when she comes out.
Brilliant.
Thank you very much for now. Alex Zane! First of your mugshot entries, and the one and only Nikki Graham meets the ladies of the Women's Institute.
Probably why I give you so many opportunities.
Sorry.
Bless you.
Yep. Pretty much like that for 3 minutes. See you after the break. Welcome back. It's day night, 7:49. Now, you might remember on Sunday I was the bearer of some very good news for a change. One of you lucky viewers will actually win the chance to enter the Big Brother house and place your very mug, that's more like it, in the kitchen. Now, the chosen mug will be in the Big Brother house for the rest of the series. We'll be following its adventures with the housemates, won't we, eh, Cheeky Chops? But the mug must be worthy of its place in Big Brother history. As you can see, mugs are very important to the housemates. You tell them, Leslie.
I have marked a mug with a little bit of red nail polish.
See,
right, that's
not
going
such
to be
a bad idea.
From now on, that is my mug.
There we go. So Leslie likes the mugs. We've already had loads of applications. Here are some of the best ones. And Alex is our judge de jour. Hello, Al. How are we doing?
You never put your arm around me like you were just doing with him. Just
I will do, but later.
Okay.
You'll get your good stuff later. Hey, yeah. I like the way you were doing that.
It's
like,
good, isn't it?
Put your mouth at the end and see. Oh, I love some tea, please.
Too hot, Dermot. You always make it too hot.
OK. First one, we have Rosie and Jojo Cornick. They say their mug is no ordinary mug. It's truly the mother of all mugs. It has an ornamental cow inside. It's this one.
This one?
Yeah.
You see, my big fear is that's... I'm going to say it's the first one we've come to. That is by far the best mug on this whole board of mugs.
Oh, dear. You should have said that before. You'd have put it last.
Oh, OK. Well, should we move it?
OK. Put it
right,
down
so
there.
This one down here is by far the best mug. However,
yeah.
You've got to think about the housemate who's going into the house to deliver it, right?
OK, you've got something coming up here. You want to go in, don't you?
No, I'm just saying. Yeah, it's a good mug. Look at that face.
Oh, I like that face.
No, she says, I'm a bit wily. I'm going to just, you know, run into the bedroom.
Oh, I see. Yeah, you're right, because, of course, this is the once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. You go into the house to deliver the mug itself. I just think it's a bit Frisian. Frisian? I imagine it's boiling.
You always make it too hot, Dermot.
Right, that myself. Look, just a little bit there. Rubbish, isn't it? OK, next up is from... I like her. She looks cheeky.
Beautiful eyes.
Sarah Corbett from Surrey. She wants her mug to go in because it's pink, it's pretty, and she says it needs to get out and see the world a little bit. What are your thoughts?
I want to make sure that she has a mouth, because what I don't trust... Because you can't see it.
Just think she has half a head.
I just wonder. You never know. Okay. If someone without a mouth should not be mug-making because they have no use for it.
OK, so we're not entirely sure about that. And we're just lastly here. We kind of just got in touch and just said, hey, Tony Blair, could you send us a mug? And the response we got was, I'm afraid that will not be able to provide you with what with your request. Worth asking, but not one we can get involved with. It says David. I don't know if David Cameron answered. Maybe David. No,
what,
David.
He intercepts his mail.
Yeah. I'll fix it for you, Tony.
I'll make Tony Blair really nasty.
But listen, what have you got?
Look at this.
Right. Did you bring this with you? Bless you.
Yeah, look, so basically, these are all the girls, like, leering over Ziggy, who's helpless down here and tiny. And they've got wings in case they need to attack from the air.
That's very good.
And over here, I've built a giant Big Brother of my own. And I've got a remote control and go, I obey.
Wonderful.
And it
protects
me.
The only problem with this is no contact with the outside world. And look, this is such a brilliant, lifelike version of you that I think they might know it's you and they'd fox you out. No, it's such a brilliant lifelike version of you. No, but thank you very much.
My pleasure.
Alex Zane's mug, everyone. Thank you. And Alex, thank you.
Really good.
Keep your mug shots coming in. And remember, there must be some good reasons as to why they go in the house. Catch Alex.
Yep.
Yeah. Here's the address to send him to. Don't forget, it's once in a lifetime opportunity. BBB, PO Box 636, Bournemouth, WD69BD. Thanks for now, Alex.
Thank you, Dermot.
Time for a brand new feature. Brand new spanking item. Now then. Cast your mind back to last year's housemates.
So very cold.
We've selected four of them to be our BBLBB team, and we're going to keep them very busy this summer as we send them all over Britain on a mission to scoop stories, juice the gossip, and crack investigations, all in the name of Big Brother's Little Brother. This is our premiere of the BBLBB team tonight. It's a favourite from last year, Nikki Graham. She went to find out about the world of Leslie at this year's Women's Institute AGM.
One year ago, these men and women were unleashed into the wider world from the grasp of Big Brother. We wanted to find out more about this year's housemates, but we couldn't be bothered to leave the office. That's why we hired the B Team.
I'm at the Women's Institute annual meeting here in London at the Royal Albert Hall. And we're here to find some of Leslie's friends. So I'm here to ask them a few questions and find out what goes on at the WI. There's thousands of them. Do you know Leslie? Leslie, who's gone in Big Brother? Does anyone know Leslie? No. Do any of you know Leslie?
Leslie who?
From Big Brother. What do you do at one of these places?
Today we're having a meeting.
About what?
We are going to be discussing the community hospitals.
Don't you have tea and cakes?
At our meetings we do, yes.
Well, you must know Leslie then.
No, I don't, because there are a 250,000 members.
She was nice. Oh, are you watching Big Brother?
Of course.
Oh, brilliant! We found someone!
She can't have gone through the selection process and not known really what she was going through.
Do you have, like, jumble sales?
We don't.
What about, like, Christmas bazaars?
Yes, we often, our craft
with
group...
With tombolas? Here I am with Katie, one of our younger WI members. I suppose it's a bit like the adult brownies or girl guides, isn't it?
I'm not sure about that. I mean, it's...
Or girls' brigade.
We don't learn to tie knots.
Or do the...
No.
Brownie promise.
No.
Here we have Pat, and she's one of our chairmen of the WI. So, Pat, you must have been a member for some years to become chairman.
I've been a member for 50 years.
50 years! Yes. That's dedication. What message do you think Leslie was trying to get across by going on Big Brother?
She's not on there specifically as a WI member. But we encourage WI members to do whatever takes her fancy.
She's quite a game old bird, isn't she?
Less of the old. She's not old. The WI gives you so many opportunities.
Sorry.
Bless you.
Well, good on you. And we need more members out there to join up.
We need people like you to join us.
Yes. Well, I might do. I'm thinking about it.
Don't just think, do it. And bring your friends along with you.
Right. Well, anyway, I think I'm going to shoot off now and get a cup of tea. So that's Nikki out for BBLB. Over to you, Dermot.
It's time now for Little Brother's Big Shout. Earlier we asked you, how do you think Ziggy's coping in a house full of ladies? Alex is still with us. And Rory Cambly is on the webcam. Hello, Rory.
Hello, Rory.
Rory, what are your thoughts about how Ziggy's coping?
Actually coping very well, and I think there's two options for you. He's either a heterosexual that doesn't appreciate females, or he's gay.
Okay. Thanks, Rory.
Well,
Rory, I do need to let you know that unless you know about it, there's four burglars in your house behind you. You should sort them out. All right. Also, we have an email here. I think Ziggy's coping well in the house considering he's an alpha male, but still Laura to win, says Alex. You just sent us an email. That's absolutely terrific.
Yeah, I changed my mind.
Thank you very much. Thanks to all our guests today, namely this one. Alex Zane, everyone.
Thank you.
Don't forget to watch tonight's show, 10 o'clock on Channel 4, to find out the full story of Emily's removal from the house. We are back tomorrow at 7:30. Gorgeous George is on Big Mouth tonight. Channel 4, 11:15. See you tomorrow. Take care.